हेलो, माय नेम इज़ प्रांचल गुप्ता एंड माय रोल नंबर इज़ 20MA20044। सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू डिसेंबल एंड अगेन असेंबल अ रूम हीटर विच इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज द हीट कन्वेक्टर। सो इन दिस मॉडल वी हैव एन ऑटोकट मैकेनिज्म वेर इन इफ द टेम्परेचर ऑफ कॉइल्स रीचेज अ पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर देन द सर्किट इज ऑटोमेटिकली कट ऑफ एंड वी कैन मेंटेन द टेम्परेचर। हेयर वी हैव थ्री मोड्स, cool, warm and hot. In cool, none of the coils is connected in the circuit and only the blower works and we get some air, air only, normal air. In the warm mode, only one of the coils is connected in the circuit and the heating is not as much as that is in the hot mode. In the hot mode, both the coils are connected and the heat is generated from both the coils. So first we see if it is working or not. So I plug it in. And here we can see that the fan starts moving, and from here, from the coils, we are getting air. Right, we can see this particle moving also. So it is working. Now I'll disassemble it. So here we have screws to fasten this covering over the internal parts. So I'll just open them and remove the cap. So here we can see that I've removed the upper covering, and there ideally should have been four screws, two at each side, but as it has been, it's quite old, so it has been repaired many a times, so one of the screws is missing. So talking about the internal parts, here we can see is the blower. When the switch is connected in, this blower starts moving, and here are the coils inside. Here we can see the coils, better view from this side. Here, so on connecting, on switching on the plug, these coils get warm and this blower moves, due to which air circulation begins and the air is thrown out from here and we get the warm air. And here we can see that the wires are coming from this place, and here is our switchboard where we can set whether we want cool, warm or hot mode. And here, this is the thermostat. Here, this is the thermostat, and this helps to maintain the maximum temperature of the heater. How? There is a small clip below this part also. It's not visible from here. But when the temperature increases to a particular level, the connection here is broken and the circuit is broken and the coils stop heating. So with time, when the coils again cool down or get to a lower temperature, again the connection is made. Here is some magnet is there also to make the connection again. So the circuit again is completed and the coils again start heating. And for the mechanism for how the blower moves, here we have some we have a coil here, and this is a core, metallic core. So when the plug when the switch is turned on, the magnetic field is created in this core, due to which this rotor starts moving in this direction and the blower moves. And here we have two shafts, one is here like around here, and the other is below here. Now talking about the issues that might be faced while we use the heater are like the coils which we use which are present here. Due to constant use, the element of the coils, the quality of the element deteriorates slowly, and at some point of time, due to overheating or due to continuous usage, the coils might break and we might have to replace them, right? And other issues are like the thermostat may start to malfunction, it won't break the circuit, or it will break the circuit at some other temperature as specified earlier, so the heater would get more warmer or less warmer, and this in turn will also lead to the further deterioration of coils as if the circuit is not broken in that manner. And here in the motor, we have a bearing. All the rotating parts are bearing. So with continuous usage, that bearing might get damaged. so we might have to replace that, or the coils might get burnt sometimes due to over voltage and anything. That also is a cause. And also, since the blower sucks in the air from the our covering, so dust and other particles might also get stuck or collected inside this cavity, reducing the efficiency of this heater. So we will need to clean it up regularly. And these are the major issues that are faced in its usage. So this was all about the heater. Now I'll just reassemble it again and then show that it's still working. Yes, so here I have again assembled it. I have placed the screws in their position on both sides, and it's been fastened here. And now I switch it on, switch the plug on, and we can see that it's working fine as earlier it was working. So that was my project. Thank you.